You're listening to the audio production of Who Are You Following? Audio Bible Studies by Sadie Robertson Huff, published by Harper Christian Resources and presented by the author. These audio studies are a unique learning experience. Unlike a traditional audiobook's direct narration of a book's text, this production includes high-quality live recordings that cover the important points from each chapter, as well as relevant material from other sources.
Here, and I am so excited that you have decided to do the Who Are You Following study with me. This is going to be so awesome. I believe that it will impact your personal life, your walk with Christ, and just who you are and who you're becoming. I'm so glad that you chose to be here. Let's just dive right in because we have five sessions to get through and I want to get us started. Y'all, I'll never forget whenever I turned 16 and got my driver's license. All of you just imagine the moment. You know how it feels when you get your license. There is a certain amount of coolness and confidence that comes with that little driver's license. And for me, I got it at just the perfect time, right before football season. And so I'm thinking, y'all, I'm gonna be the coolest kid in school because honestly, not many had their license yet. I was one of the first in my grades and I thought, I'm gonna be able to drive all my friends to the football game. So here's my opportunity, one of the first football games of the season, and it's an hour outside of town. And I'm like, even better, I totally got this. I'm gonna get to drive my friends for an hour. And so one brave friend decided to come with me and we were gonna make this drive to the football game. And like I said, we're feeling so cool. We get in that car, we crank up the music, we're ready to get a little dance on, talk about, you know, probably who we had a crush on, all the things, and drive to this football game. Well, of course, I put it in the maps on my phone to make sure I know where I'm going. And I also turn that up loud so I make sure I get to where I'm going. Well, of course I get there, we have a great game, everything's great. And then we decided to leave the game and go back home. And as we left, me feeling super confident and cool, the 16-year-old with her license, I'm like, you know what? Who needs the GPS? I got this. That was such a simple drive. All I had to do was make like one turn and then just like drive a while. And then I was here. So on the way back, I'll just make one turn, drive a while, and I end up home. Well, friends, let me just tell you, the one turn I had to make, I made the wrong turn. But I didn't realize I made the wrong turn as I'm driving for about 45 minutes. And what's crazy is I literally thought I was recognizing the sights I was seeing. I was like, oh yeah, I remember that house. Oh yeah, I remember that. We must be getting close to home. Well, about an hour goes by and I'm like, you know, we should actually be seeing like our house right now. I'm thinking this is starting to not really look like what I thought we were gonna end up at as we've driven an hour. So I looked to my left and I'll never forget, there was a post office and it said Eudora, Arkansas. Y'all, I live in Louisiana, not Arkansas. I was literally in the wrong state. And I'm just gonna tell you, all of my coolness and all of my confidence went out the window in that moment. I'm sitting there and I'm like, not only feeling uncool and unconfident, I'm also feeling very afraid, very insecure, a little bit embarrassed. And I'm sitting here and what really came into the reality of my mind at this moment is I'm lost. And friends, that is a terrible feeling, to feel lost. It is one that will make you feel afraid. It is one that will make you feel embarrassed. It is one that will make you feel hopeless at times. And I think in a spiritual sense, many of you feel the same way. You took a wrong turn in life. You took a turn that you didn't really mean to take, and you've gone down this road for so long that you don't recognize anything around you. You don't recognize who you've become, and you're sitting here and the fear's starting to rise up, the anxiety's starting to rise up, you're feeling a little hopeless, and you just simply feel lost. And what I came to terms with in that moment is not only am I lost, but also I don't know how to get back home. And maybe you feel the same way. Not only am I lost, but I don't even know how to get back home. But here's the thing that I realized in that moment. I have a GPS. I can just type it back in, and there will be a voice that will guide me back home. And for you, I want to give you the encouragement that it's the same way. The voice of the Lord is here to guide you back home, to get you back to who you know you've always been called to be, who He called you to be in your mother's womb. That voice is going to guide you back home. But we need to look at a few things to get there, friends. And that's what we're going to do in these next few sessions. Here's the thing. If you're anything like me, I know you might be a person who needs a plan. And so I'm going to give you a general plan for our time as we dive into this study together. We're going to talk about who we're following and where all this following is leading us. We're going to get honest about if we're really happy about where it's led us so far. We're going to talk about where we actually want to end up. If all of this following is leading us somewhere that we actually want to go, it's actually a really important question that we can ask ourselves. We're going to talk about what it will cost us to stay focused on the path we want to be on and to quit taking spiritually equivalent trips to Arkansas. Does that sound like a plan? All right, let's roll. Now I'm just going to go ahead and call this out. If you're currently flipping back and forth between this video and your Instagram, I just want to go ahead and ask that you put that away, get rid of the distractions, and give this study your full attention. You might be wondering how I knew you were multitasking, how I knew that your eyes were darting back and forth from this session to social media. And honestly, guys, the reason I knew that is because if you're a human being alive on the planet in the 21st century, then you're most likely always on your phone. And hey, to be honest, I would be too. But literally, we're always on our phone. You want proof? Because I got some. Here's the facts. How about this? A group of researchers recently studied our digital device usage trends and found that half of us take our phones into public restrooms and use them while we're taking care of business. And I'm not even gonna lie to y'all, I'm a part of that half, okay? Don't even lie, you know you are too. Y'all, we are addicted. The same group of researchers also studied how often we clean our phones. Any guesses? If you guess, never, you win. I mean, I don't clean my phone, and you know what? That is so gross. But does that stop us? No. We're walking down a city street, we're scrolling our phone. We're stopped at a traffic light, we scroll our phone. We're waiting to board a plane, we scroll our phone. And even sometimes we're out on a nice date with someone we really actually love and are very interested in. But yeah, you guessed it, we scroll our phone. Surely we stop scrolling our phone when we sleep, right? Wrong. Nearly 7 in 10 people admit to scrolling their social media feeds until the moment that they drift their eyes to sleep. Many even fall asleep while they are scrolling, their phone suspended in midair, their thumbs pressing their screen, and their eyes totally shut.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.